Well, hello everybody. This is Pastor Mike Burns from Tulsa, Oklahoma, and it's 9 o'clock Central Time here in Tulsa, and it's time for our Wednesday edition of God's Healing Word. And as we're coming into this wonderful season of Christmas, I hope you're getting all your things done that you need to get done, all your shopping and other type of things you're doing. I know my mom has been busy baking all kinds of cookies, and I'm looking forward to the blessings she's going to give all of her family, her kids and grandkids. And Mom, I just want you to know that we appreciate you very much. I love you, and so thankful that we still have you even at this stage of your life, and know it will be many, many more years, praise God. Also, I just want to thank you for your friendship. You know, we've had many of our friends helping us as we've been getting ready to leave. I leave this Saturday, just in three more days. I'm leaving for Florida to go bring our belongings that we have in storage back here to Broken Arrow, Oklahoma, where we now live. Cynthia and I just got a brand new place to live. And so we thank God for our family that's helped us when we first moved here. But now we have our own place, and we're very excited about it. And I've been asking for friends that would help us with the expense of this move. And several have stepped up and have been a real blessing. And we want to just say to all of you who have helped us far, thank you so much. And we know there is still a ways that we have to go, and there are others of you that will help us as well. And I'm not only talking about prayerfully, because certainly we need your help when it comes to prayer, but also we also want to be able to pay for the expenditures that will be involved in this great move here. We have a friend going with me Saturday morning. Brother John will be flying to Tampa, getting a ride from Tampa Airport to Bradenton, picking up a 26-foot U-Haul trailer, a truck actually, a 26-footer, going to our storage bin where we have two bins, two storage places. One is a 5x10, the other is a 10x15, and they're all filled up, and we're going to load them up. Pastor back in Florida has made a commitment to me that he was going to see what he could do to get people to help me. Other friends are helping also with some of these logistics, and I just want to say to them, thank you for your help, and we're looking forward to hearing from you as the days are drawing closer. And if you'd like to help us with the financial aspect of this, we still have a little ways to go here. You can go to our website, mjbministries.org, and you can click on the giving page and make a one-time gift, or become a partner by putting your information right there. You can also give, as someone did this morning, on the Cash App, $MJB Ministries. That's $MJB Ministries, and make your contribution that way. And you can also text the letters MJBMIN to 45777. That's MJBMIN to 45777. And this is a very special ask here, as we're getting ready, as I said, to move our belongings from storage in Florida to here in Oklahoma. And so thank you in advance for all you that are going to that have yet to help and will help us with some of these expenses. I appreciate it. You know, my wife and I spent 35 years of our life in Long Island pastoring and giving our lives there. For people there. And so we are very thankful that God used us, and now is using us in a new phase of ministry, which involves itinerating, book writing, and social media, which you're experiencing right now. So we're very, very thankful. Hey, don't forget to sign up for our free monthly e-newsletter on our website right now, or you can download, and it just got released this past week, our MJB Ministry mobile app, MJB Ministries with an S, plural, app, mobile app on the Google Play Store and on the Apple App Store. They're free to download, and they have all kinds of great stuff there. I really hope you'll take advantage of that. We put some effort into putting it together. There is a monthly cost for it for us, And we're certainly not passing it on to our friends, but it's got resources that will help you in a great way. There's a free Bible, prayer requests, links to our archive, our e-newsletters, ways to sign up for a newsletter. There's other great links to our YouTube channel and things there on that site. And we're looking to do live streaming through our app as well. We haven't got there yet, but we're going to see what is involved with that. And we thank God for the opportunity there as well. Now, today we're going to continue our teaching on signs, wonders, and miracles. And we're talking about how to have miracles. And we're talking about two disciples. We've already covered one of them. And we started yesterday talking about the second disciple, not a fivefold ministry gift, that was used in a great and a supernatural way. And we're going to talk about that here in a minute. Before we do, let's have a word of prayer today. Father, in the name of the Lord Jesus, I just give you praise and thanks for this broadcast today of God's healing word. It was 5 years ago, last June and July, you healed me. I received my healing, I should say, of 7 strokes in 3 parts of my brain. And I've been faithful to teach your word here, Father God, over 5 years now, to the people who are suffering and people that are being equipped to stand in the evil day if it tries to show up in their lives. And I thank you even tonight as we continue to teach on this, that Father, you'll think through my mind and speak through my lips to your people. Holy Spirit, I'm asking you to cause every ear to be a listening ear, every mind an open mind, and every heart a receptive heart to both the things of the Word and of the Holy Spirit of God. We welcome your supernatural gifts of the Holy Spirit with signs, wonders, and miracles accompanying the preaching and teaching of the Word of God that I'll go forth tonight. And Father, as always, we covenant with you now at the very beginning of the show today to give you all the glory, the honor, the praise, and the thanks for everything that will be said, done, revealed, and manifested in Jesus' name. And everybody who agreed with that prayer said, amen, praise God. And so we're very excited about that. And we're going to get into the teaching right now. Praise God. If you have your Bibles, I'd like you to turn with me. We're going to be in Acts, the 10th chapter, as we were yesterday. We started talking about the life of a man who was just a believer, a Gentile believer at that, by the name of Cornelius. Now, we already read part of the story in Acts 10, but let's read verses 1 through 6 again. It says there was a certain man in Caesarea called Cornelius, a centurion of the Italian band, and he was a devout man and one that feared God with all of his house, which gave much alms to the people and prayed to God always. He saw in a vision, evidently about the 9th hour of the day, an angel of God coming into him and saying unto him, Cornelius. And when he looked on him, he was afraid and said, What is it, Lord? And he said unto him, Your prayers and your alms or your giving are come up for a memorial before God. And now send men to Joppa and call for one Simon, whose surname is Peter. He lodges with one Simon a tanner, whose house is by the seaside. He shall tell thee what you should do. Praise God. Now we said yesterday in some of the background, if you want more of that, then listen to yesterday's broadcast, which I know you'll be greatly blessed by. It's right here on our Facebook page. Just scroll down and you'll find it. But we have this case here of a layman named Cornelius who worked as a Roman centurion. Now, he wasn't a preacher. He wasn't a pastor or a fivefold ministry gift, but he had a reverence for God through prayer and much giving. Now, what's interesting here is that his giving, his prayers, literally, the angel of God said they built a memorial. They had come up as a memorial before God. You know, we have in D.C. what we call the Washington Memorial. It's a great big tower right there in the middle of the mall there in Washington, D.C., with all the other House of Representatives and Congress and all that's there, the White House, and many other great memorials to Vietnam veterans and to World War I, World War II. We have so many memorials, Korean conflict. We have so many things there in D.C. It kind of reminds me a little bit of when you go to Gettysburg, Pennsylvania, which I've been to. I can't even tell you how many times I've been there. I had family and relatives that lived there. And there are monuments everywhere for the different divisions for the Union Army, the Confederate Army, for different colonels and sergeants and different people that died. And, you know, there's you see men on horses, and some of them have all four legs on the ground. Some have one leg up in the air, and it means, you know, either they lived or they perished in the battles there. You can go and actually find actual bullets that were used and fired during the Civil War. Some of them are replicas, but you can actually get some of the actual bullets that were fired by some of the soldiers during the Civil War. But one of my point is that there are many memorials that are there in Gettysburg, just like in D.C., and it says here about Cornelius that his prayers and his giving had come up literally as a memorial before God. And that really opened my eyes many years ago and helped me to see that God is looking at what we do, whether we're a fivefold minister or just or a believer. You know, it's not in an office of ministry per se. And when we give and when we pray, and I'm talking about on a regular basis, not once in a blue moon, but when we really have a lifestyle like that, we're actually creating memorials in heaven that God pays attention to. Now, I made this statement that God sees everything that you and I do, no matter where we may work or where we go. As a matter of fact, you could be a worker, we said, in the secular world and have God speak to you and lead you in doing miracles right where you are. And I gave you an example yesterday of when I was 17 years old in a factory I'd worked in that was a gear factory, and all these people from all around the world, these immigrants, worked there. And I had a chance to lead, I don't even know how many people, there must have been 40 or 50 on each floor, and I led many of them to Christ. And God opened a door for me on a Saturday to share the message of God's love and grace through Jesus Christ with them. Amazing. And it was just a beautiful, beautiful opportunity. Well, you can have the same opportunities where you work, where you live, in your neighborhood, in your grocery store. I heard this story of one gentleman that he was on his way home, and he was a Christian, spiritual believer, and he wanted, just suddenly had a desire for donuts. I know it's kind of crazy. You might say, well, that's the devil. That's not God. Well, in this case, it really was the Lord putting in his heart to stop at this particular store, this grocery store, and pick up some donuts. And while he was standing online to pay for the donuts at this cash register, he noticed the person in front of him, you know, had a problem walking with a cane and a lot of pain. It was obvious. And he asked the woman if he could pray with her. And the woman, you know, talked with the woman, and the woman agreed to let him pray. And when he prayed, she was instantly healed. I mean, she could move. She didn't need her cane. She was amazed at the power of God. The cancer lady was amazed as well. And so this man got bold, and he said, he asked the lady at the register at a microphone for the speaker system in the store, and said, would you mind if I made an announcement? And so she hands him the microphone. And over the loudspeaker of this grocery store, this man said, he said, I want you to know, shoppers, today God's doing miracles at checkout counter number 9. And if you'll come here right now, God will do miracles in your life and healing in your life. If you need healing, come down right now. We just had a woman healed of arthritis, and it's wonderful. And he handed the mic back, and, you know, next thing you know, these people came from all over the store to check out aisle, whatever it was, number 9 or whatever the number was. And he began to pray for people. People were healed in issues with their eyes, issues with the ears. One big man came at this young Christian, and he would look like he was going to attack him. But he said, I'm actually a concert pianist, and I have carpal tunnel syndrome. And I make my living with my hands, and I'm in so much pain, it's hard for me to play the piano anymore. He prayed for him, and God instantly healed this man of carpal tunnel syndrome. And, you know, I don't know how many people he led to Christ that day, but on that next Sunday, he filled up 2 rows of these people in church, glory to God, brought them to come to church with him. And they all gave their hearts to Christ. And I mean, just a tremendous, tremendous miracle. Praise God. Well, this guy who did this wasn't necessarily a fivefold minister. He wasn't an apostle, prophet, evangelist, pastor, or teacher. He was a believer. And God used him in that grocery store, and it all started over donuts. Well, you see, God can work in your life is what I'm trying to say to you. Now, we know that Peter had this vision on the housetop of Simon the Tanner, meaning he was a man that dealt with all kinds of animal skins, probably something that a good Jewish man shouldn't be around because it was against Jewish law. But he was on the housetop praying, and he falls into a trance, we said yesterday, and he saw the vision of these four hooked animals coming out of on this great big sheet. God said, kill and eat. And Peter three times said, not so, Lord. I've never touched anything uncommon or unclean on these Jewish lips. And three times he saw that vision in this trance he had. And God was trying to show Peter that God wanted to reach not just the Jewish people, but he also wanted to reach the Gentile world. And so we come down here to verse number 17. Now it says, after this vision Peter had, now while Peter doubted in himself what this vision which he had seen should mean, behold, the men which were sent from Cornelius had made inquiry for Simon's house and stood before the gate. And they called and they asked whether Simon was, which was surnamed Peter, were lodged there. And while Peter thought on the vision, the Holy Spirit said unto him, behold, three men, they seek you. Arise therefore and get thee down and go with them, doubting nothing, for I have sent them. Now, the question arises, did Peter have miracles in his life and his ministry? Well, the obvious answer about Peter, the Apostle Peter, was of course he did. Yeah, he had miracles and healings in his life and his ministry. But how, we ask the question today, how did he have these miracles and these healings? The answer is what we've been saying. It started with Mary at the wedding of Cana with Jesus' first miracle. Whatever he says to you, do it. Peter had miracles and healings in his ministry and his life because he heard from God and he obeyed. The same thing that happened with Ananias. He had miracles as a believer with the apostle Paul, who was at the time called Saul of Tarsus, and he went because he heard from God and he obeyed God. Now Peter is hearing from God and he is obeying God as well. And so we skip on down here as Peter goes to Cornelius' house, and there's a house full of people. I don't know how many people were there, but there was a whole bunch there. And Cornelius had gathered them to hear words from Peter. And Peter begins to share with them the message of Christ, is the grace of God, the love of God, the importance of receiving Jesus and the salvation that is found in him alone. And it says in verse 44, something that is just so powerful and so beautiful, that while Peter yet spake these words, the Holy Ghost fell on all them which heard the word. Now, it's interesting here that Peter hardly got to talk and the Holy Ghost interrupted him, but he did it in a supernatural way. You know, I don't mind the Holy Spirit interrupting me if he wants to move in our services. I had that happen. I told you several weeks back, I was ministering at a church in Long Island, Perfecting Faith Church, with my good friend Donnie McClurk, and some of you know him as a gospel singer, but he actually is a pastor of a great church in Freeport, Long Island, New York. And he had me coming to do a month of teaching on Wednesdays on divine healing. Well, while I was just teaching the word, that's all I was doing. The anointing was there. The Holy Spirit was certainly present. A young woman got up and started shouting and interrupted me. And I thought, well, what's happened over there? And she was sitting to my right. And she said to me, she said, the Holy Spirit has just come on me in a great way. I have no cartilage in my knees, and I have bone on bone rubbing against each other. I've been in pain, and the doctors have been talking about doing, in both my knees, a double knee replacement surgery. But while you were teaching the word, Brother Mike, and this is what she said to me, Pastor Mike, while you were teaching the word, the Spirit of God came on me, like power came on me, and I felt my knees, something happened in my knees, and I got up, and I'm done jumping, I'm jumping, and I had to get out of the aisle. She ran up and down the aisle, jumped and danced and rejoiced. God had literally given her a creative miracle. I was gloriously interrupted. I didn't do it. I can't take any credit for it. I was just teaching the word. But the Lord himself gave her what she needed in that moment. Now, she received what he had already done for her, because by his stripes we were healed, past tense, meaning it happened when Jesus took the stripes on his back over 2,000 years ago. But this woman was, I got interrupted by this dear sister as she was instantly and miraculously healed. Well, that's what happened with Peter here. While he had spake these words, the Holy Ghost fell. I'm telling you, we need to have services in our churches today where we're speaking the words of God and the Holy Spirit, the Holy Ghost is falling, glory to God, on all of them that are hearing the word. And it says in verse 45 here of Acts 10, and they of the circumcision which believe were astonished, as many as came with Peter. Why? Because that on the Gentiles, not the Jews people only, but now on the Gentiles also was poured out the gift of the Holy Ghost, for they heard them speak with tongues and magnify God. Then Peter answered and said, can any man forbid water that these should not be baptized, which have received the Holy Ghost as well as we? And he commanded them to be baptized in the name of the Lord. Then they prayed him to tarry for certain days, praise God, which he did, and helped them in their newfound relationship with God. You know what I find interesting about this whole story here is many times what I've seen happen is people receive Christ and are born again, and then they're baptized in the Holy Spirit, and they start speaking in tongues. In this case, they spoke in tongues, and they got saved and spoke in tongues, and then they were baptized in water, which was their outward confession. And so it doesn't matter to me what order it happens in. You know, as long as it happens, praise God. Amen. And I'm glad for it. You know, I'm going to say this as we close today's broadcast, that we need to draw closer to the Lord and become more intimately acquainted with him as individuals and also collectively as a church body. Now, as we do, you know what's going to happen? We're going to discern his voice clearer and clearer above the noise that's found in this world. In other words, we're going to be able to hear from him. And as we hear and obey, guess what's going to happen? We're going to see the greater works that cause us, and not just us, but even other people to marvel at the things that God will do. Praise God. Signs, wonders, and miracles. We've spent now a couple of months teaching from this series. Tomorrow we're going to be on something different, and then Friday on Stewardship Friday. And then the next 2 weeks we're going to be talking about the miracle of Christmas. I know you're not going to want to miss it, praise God. I'm Pastor Mike Burns, no longer in the pastorate. I did that for 35 years in Long Island, New York with my beautiful wife, Cynthia. And today I am living now back in Tulsa, Oklahoma. I'm a graduate with my wife at Rhema Bible Training College. 1981, we attended there. We weren't married. We didn't even know each other. We met 3.5 years later and got married. I've been married now 36 wonderful years, praise God. Now, today, on this particular Wednesday, I want to thank you for tuning in today. I want to encourage pastors to order a free copy of my book, Church Happens. It's my newest book, my latest book, Church Happens, What Your Pastor Needs from the People They Lead. I want to send this to every pastor who's watching me today, praise God. And if you'll watch, then you can go to churchhappensbook.com, churchhappensbook.com, and there you can scroll down slightly and you'll see a tab, get your copy for pastors only, it's free, and you can have this copy by filling in your email address, and we will send you a PDF of this book in its entirety, along with bulk ordering discount information. I really want to send this to you as a pastor. And if you're a pastor, staff, or your assistant pastors, you can order it as well. I'll send it to you free. Now, if you're not a pastor, you have to order it, and you have the honor and the privilege of paying for it, and we'll ship it out to you ASAP. Pastors, I also have this book. It's also for everybody, but for pastors, I have this as a 4-hour seminar I do on a Saturday where churches are inviting us to come. We teach this series with this companion study guide on Discover the Life You Were Born to Live. It's a 4-hour Saturday seminar with lunch in between. Now, we give, we charge $30 per person, and it's $25 for the two books here. and $5 we collect for lunch that we give to the host church who provides the lunch for those who attend. And so we believe, God, for a great time in ministry to the people there on this four-hour Saturday seminar, which with breaks in between. And let me say, when we come for that, we'd like to come and also stay for Sunday morning and minister a dynamic word to your church and then host a great miracle and healing rally on Sunday nights. Now, we have experience. I have over 35 years of pastoral experience, over 40 years of experience is traveling and other ministry experiences I've had. I've been over 14 countries, and we have really something to share with people. My wife and I have a combined ministry experience of over 80 years together. If you put it together, that's what we have. And we can be a blessing to every church, every ministry. I don't care if you're holding a conference, camping, seminar, we can come and be a help and help you do what God's called you to do and add value to you, to your church, to your staff, and to your community. Praise God. Now, if you want us to come, go to mjbministries.org/invite. That's mjbministries.org/invite. And we'd be happy to come and to be with you. Now, we are booking for 2022 right now. And so make your request now. Go to mjbministries.org/invite and fill out that invitation. It's a short form. We'll be in contact with you, talk about dates, all the requirements for us to come, and travel and hotel and meals and all that, and honorarium and offering or whatever the Lord we decide on mutually and agree together. And we will not be a burden. We will be a blessing. And that's our goal, to add value and be a blessing to you and your community of faith and of your community in your city. Praise God. Don't forget now, you can get our free e-newsletter if you sign up on our website for the free e-newsletter we send out on the first of every month. And if you sign up today, we will send you the December newsletter. We even have our archives on our website. You could visit there at mjbministries.org and then go to the archives section, and you'll see up and through November our newsletter there as well. As well as the past 11 though, that we have, and you can enjoy them. We have our MJB Ministries mobile app for both the Google Play Store and the Apple App Store. It's free to download. Search for MJB Ministries. You can get it there with great helpful resources to help you grow in grace and in the knowledge of the Lord. Thank you for sharing this video with your friends on your Facebook timeline, your Twitter, all your social platforms. Share the link here, and I know if you do, you'll be blessed. Now, we're going to get ready to do the replay, and we'll have the link for it, for the Vimeo link. Wait till we have that up before you share it, and I know once you do, you'll be glad that you did. Also, don't forget, we are also going to be leaving Saturday morning to go to Florida to move our belongings from storage from Florida back here to Oklahoma, where we've now relocated. And we really need the help of our friends. Several have already stepped up. We need a little more help. And so if you could go to our website, mjbministries.org, go to the giving page and make a donation tonight, I would really appreciate it. Or you can give through Cash App, which is $MJBMinistries. And you can also text the letters MJBMIN to 45777. And now if you'll go there and do that today, put in your information, make your donation, either a one-time gift or even become a partner, we would really appreciate it. This move is costing us more than we have on hand right now, but we believe we'll have enough by the time we're going to do it. And another way that's going to happen is if people like you step up and say, Pastor Mike, I'm going to help you and Cynthia do what you are doing to move you here to Oklahoma. Praise God. Thank you for your help. Thank you for responding again. That's Cash App is $MJBMinistries. And then also you can text MJBMIM to 45777. Praise God. Thank you for helping us. And thank you for being our friends today. We love you so very much. And we'll see you tomorrow on the broadcast. Have a wonderful, wonderful day. Praise God.